Here we're asked to solve this linear inequality. The steps are pretty much the same as algebra, except whenever you divide or multiply by a negative number, you have to reverse the inequality. I think we're going to have to do that here. So the first thing I notice is that I'll have to subtract 2 on both sides. Okay, that'll leave me with a negative 3x is greater than 15. Okay, do not reverse the inequality when you subtract. Here, algebra is telling me I have to isolate the x, right? To get 1x, I'm going to have to divide both sides by negative 3 so that these negative 3s cancel. Okay, when I do that, I get x, but since I'm dividing by a negative 3, I have to reverse the inequality, okay? So instead of greater than, now I'm going to write that as less than or equal to negative 5. Now, it's always helpful to actually check your answers at this point. This tells me I have infinitely many solutions. Anything less than or equal to negative 5 should work. So, for example, negative 10 should solve the original inequality. So let's look at this. Negative 3 times negative 10 is positive 30, right? 30 plus 2 is 32, and that's going to be greater than 17. So it works. Now, depending on the question, he's going to ask you to write your answer in interval notation or graph your answers on a number line. So I'm going to do both. Since I have infinitely many solutions, I'm going to shade in all the numbers that work. And I'm going to choose a good scale here. I'm going to start at 0, go by 5. So negative 5, negative 10, negative 15, and so on. Now, we have an equal there, right? That means negative 5 works. That's inclusive. So here I'm going to use a close dot and shade all the numbers less than negative 5. Okay, this indicates infinitely many solutions. Any one of these numbers that's shaded should solve the original inequality. Now let's write that in interval notation. Okay, so negative infinity lives over here. Positive infinity lives out there now. To convert this graph into interval notation, I'll say from negative infinity up to negative 5. It's inclusive, so since I'm using a closed dot, I would use a square bracket like that. That indicates inclusiveness. Never use a square bracket on infinity, okay? You can never actually attain it, so you always want to use the regular parentheses for that.